Instead, let's go to our contribution.
All right, come on, bro.
And our contribution, the money we collect, this will go to the ministry, to the church.
Exactly.
The work in the church. Amen?
Bro.
I'd like to share to you a scripture here.
Yep.
Give you a charge for our contribution. You can go to our Bible in Luke chapter 14. And we can start in verse 15. Luke 14, verse 15. This is actually the parable of the great banquet.
Come on, bro.
All right. You guys there?
Yep.
It says here, verse 15. When one of those at the table with him heard this, he said to Jesus, "Blessed is the one who will eat at the feast in the kingdom of God." Jesus replied, "A certain man was preparing a great banquet and invited many guests. At the time of the banquet, he sent his servant to tell those who had been invited, 'Come, for everything is now ready.' But they all alike began to make excuses. The first said, 'I have just bought a field and I must go and see it. Please excuse me.' Another said, 'I have just bought 5 yoke of oxen and I'm on my way to try them out. Please excuse me.' Still another said, 'I just got married, so I can't come.' But the servant came back and reported this to his master. And the owner of the house became angry and ordered his servant, 'Go out quickly into the streets and alleys of the town and bring in the poor, the crippled, the blind, and the lame.' 'Sir,' the servant said, 'what you ordered has been done, but there is still room.' Then the master called his servant, 'Go out to the roads and country lanes and compel them to come in, so that my house will be full. I tell you, not one of those who were invited will get a taste of my banquet.'"
Oh, wow.
You know, this is very, very relatable to our lives, amen? As disciples, this is the same charge that we have. Yeah. We go out there and invite people so that for them to hear the words of God.
Amen.
And there are a few things here I'd like to emphasize.
Come on, bro. Yeah. Come on,
like
bro.
Number one, I think it's the heart of the master, the king. You know, the king wants every single person to be invited.
Wow.
He wants every single person to be there and to enjoy the party. He prepared a great banquet. He wants every single person to enjoy.
Wow.
And to share in his happiness. And then, of course, this banquet. You know, of course, today, maybe that's like a wedding reception.
Wow.
You know, it's always a great honor to be invited to a wedding reception, wow. Right?
Yeah. Excited, bro.
And we're excited for Aki and Lou's wedding. You know, but in the past, the wedding reception in the past actually would last like several days.
Wow.
You know, like they have stages. Stage one, stage two, something like that. That's how they celebrated. In fact, in the book of Esther, you can read King Xerxes there. You know, he gave a banquet from the least to the greatest for 7 days.
Oh, wow.
The banquet that this king, King Xerxes, gave to his kingdom at the time was like 7 days.
Amazing.
And all the people from the least to the greatest, they were like, that place, that palace, that garden, they were all accommodated.
Amazing.
They were given a room. They were given servants to take care of their needs. They can do whatever they want. There are functions. There's like, you know, there's a function in the morning, buffet breakfast,
that's right.
Function in the afternoon, function in the evening. There's like a party for 7 days. Wow. I can't imagine. Today, you know, if you translate it today, 7 days. Try to imagine if Aki and Lou decide to invite all of us.
Wow.
7 days and 7 nights, Shangri-La Matan.
Wow.
All the buffet breakfast. We have all access to the amenities, to the pool, to the water sports, and everything. 7 days of great vacation. Are you guys coming?
Yeah.
We should be coming. Kind of invitation. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, bro.
But you see, there are so many excuses here. You know, the excuse here was like, I just bought a field, I just bought oxen, I just got married. So these are like, you know, excuses. job. You know, we are living in a country that's not very, very wealthy, right? Poverty is really an issue in our country. And I can totally understand that because there was a time in my life I struggled with poverty.
Wow.
You know, maybe right now you would think, really? Yeah, but at that time, I don't have a job. Mind you, I applied to 70 companies.
Wow.
70. I went, sent application to them, walking because I was at those bisina. Yung mga sakit na, piskan na ko sa ulan, di ba? So, I was at that time, but I never missed church.
Wow.
I never missed Bible talk.
Awesome.
And I remember that time, I don't know if Jimmy can still remember, I would ask money from the brothers, 5 pesos each, so that I can go home, I can have pamasahe to go home. Akong dituyot na siya, 5 pesos lang, kaya ako sa'yo na pangayuman. I go to one brother, bro, okay, 5, you know? Until it reaches 20, I have enough to go home. Amen. I do that every single day. Every time we have like meetings in our Bible talk. But that should not stop us. Poverty should not stop us serving the Lord. Amen.
Come on, bro.
And another point here is we are the servants. We work to invite guests. We work hard to invite all kinds of people. And there are people who will maulaw-ulaw. May mga tao na, pugsun pa. You have to find a way. You have to be creative. And then there are people, it hurts when people reject us. It hurts when people don't respond. But we don't give up. Amen?
Yep. Come on.
We persevere.
Amen.
We become creative. We work as a team. And we will have fun doing it. Amen? And then number 5 is that's why we give our contribution.
Amen.
Because we invest in God's business.
Amen.
You know, we support God's business.
Right. Come on, bro.
You know, today, many people, they believe in investment.
Yeah.
And so what they did, they invest their money, their time, and their effort because they believe that that business will grow and will have great rewards one day.
That's right.
And mostly, of course, financial rewards. It will provide for their family. It will pay off our debts. And it will give us better life. Because money somehow is the answer for many things. Right?
Yeah.
But you know, right now, we invest in God's business. We give our money, we give our time, we give our effort because we know this is the most important thing in life.
Yep, that's right.
The rewards are great.
Amen.
People's life will change.
Yep.
Their sins will be forgiven.
Awesome.
They can be forgiven. Amen. And the Holy Spirit can be with them. Their lives will change.
Awesome.
They can live a life of purity, a life of a wonderful life.
Awesome.
Amen?
Awesome.
And not only that, we have heaven one day.
Amen.
In heaven, we have a lot of rooms.
Amen.
We have mansions in heaven. We can visit.
Wow.
I would like to invite all the guys to this when we get there one day. We'll have like 1 year of spend time.
Wow.
Because we have all the years there. We don't get bored. Okay? Guys, the rewards are great. That's why we are here. We're going to invest in God's business.
Amen.
And we give our contribution because this will support the ministry. And the money that we have, we will turn this, change this, make this into a soul being saved.
Amen.
Amen.
Awesome.
Let's go again in prayer.
Awesome.
Our Father in heaven, thank you so much, God, for today, Father.
Yes.
Thank you, God, that you save us, Father. Thank you, God, that our sins are forgiven. Thank you, God, that we have heaven to look forward to, Father.
Yes.
And God, today, thank you as well that we are one of your workers.
Yes.
Thank you that you are called us, God. We don't deserve to be working for you.
Yep.
We have done so many stupid things in our life, Father, but God, you believe in us. You wanted us to be part of this wonderful team, Father.
Yes.
So, Father, I pray, help us, Father, that we can continue to support your plans, God. The ministry, Father. The money we give today, I know, God, this will convert to souls, Father.
Amen.
Thank you so much for everything we've done.